Throughout time, mankind, I should say, has had these special little times and places. You know, you had Ernest Hemingway and Picasso in Paris in the 1920s. Something magic happens where people get together and they share their energy and, you know, the sum becomes greater than the parts. And I think that was the case with Bakersfield, 1954, 55, 56. But you put all that talent together and this magical thing happens.
And most people, you know, see the face of it as Buck and Merle because they were the superstars that came out. But it was all the pioneers that paved the road before them. You know, it was all those guys that came before them that really made it happen.
It's been said that a honky-tonk attitude is what makes the Bakersfield sound different. It comes from working people. It isn't polished. It's raw, energetic. It makes you want to move. It can also be said that the honky-tonk attitude came from the spirit of the Dust Bowl immigrants. It sprang from the hearts of Okies who came to California to seek a better life in the land of milk and honey. The Nashville sound is from the studio. The Bakersfield sound is from the street.
Country music in Bakersfield is something that is to be proud of all over the world. This one little city, there's no other place on the planet that has that to represent like we do. Now, Nashville is a business community of music, but we made a sound. We created a sound here like no other city in the world.
The music came from the honky-tonks, the Bakersfield sound.
I just like to thank all the folks that come out to see me while I was here.